welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Want to send a shout out to David. David's in Singapore. A couple weeks ago, David was having dinner, and he happened to be sitting with my brother. So when he was introduced and heard that it was Bob Jellin, he said, "Wait a second, you're not related to that Mr. Excel guy, are you?" Which I thought was very cool. So David, thanks for freaking my brother out halfway around the world. Today I want to talk about trend lines and how to do forecasting with trend lines. So I have some sales here for the first 12 months, and I want to see what they're going to be for the next 12 months. Well, we could try and use LINEST, which is relatively hard to use because it's an array formula. But even easier than that, just right click on the line, and choose Add Trend Line. Now, if your data seems to be growing in a linear fashion, so it's adding 20 a month or 30 a month or something like that, we can choose linear. And I always like to see what the equation is, so display equation on the chart and click OK. And it draws a trend line in. I always think that the trend line is a bit too solid, especially since it's kind of a forecast. So I always will format that trend line and kind of kick it back to thinner and a dotted style, maybe even a different color. Click OK. But we'll see here that basically they think that we are increasing by about 100 a month. So on average, 900 plus 100 each month, 102 each month. And so that's a simple way to do a linear trend line. But sometimes your sales aren't following a linear pattern. Here I have sales that are actually kind of multiplying each month. Each month we're selling, you know, the previous month time some factor. We're having this tremendous growth. And if we would add a trend line here, add trend line, and choose linear, it's going to be a horrible trend line. It, you know, it's not close anywhere. But we want to change that trend line and choose, instead of linear, maybe exponential. So exponential means that every month we're selling a percentage over the previous month. And so the numbers keep growing. Now again, here I want to format that trend line to make it a little bit less prominent. And we can see in this case the trend line projects continuous growth. Now there's other types of trend lines in there. For example, here's a polynomial trend line. That's where if somehow your data would be a constant plus some number times the month plus some number times the month squared. Certainly scientific data would fall into that category. Probably not something you're going to see when you're doing sales forecasting, but there's certainly those options there. Also logarithmic and powers and moving averages. Sometimes, depending if you have seasonal data, the moving average might be the best way to go. So we can create different trend lines there. Now, in all of these, the one thing that I did up front was I made sure to include extra series in my chart. If you hadn't done that, if you would have just created the chart based on the original numbers, then we would have to ask Excel to extend the trend line into the future. So when we format the trend line on the Options tab, we can say we want to go forward maybe 12 periods, and that will force Excel to extend the chart. I always think about it in advance. I make sure to leave plenty of extra space. That way I don't have to go in and change that setting, but certainly you can do it. So thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.